It was recently leaked that Halo Infinite is not going to launch with a Battle Royale, but rather a Big Team Battle 2.0. But recent information comes around saying that you might be able to make that BR mode in Forge, but is that the right way to go about doing it? Well, in this video, we're going to all the details. How's it going, everybody? It's Kevin here once again, giving our news and informational video when it comes to Halo. If you like these kind of videos, make sure to tap that like button. Lets me know you want to see some more content like this. Want to stay up to date with all the news happening in Halo? Make sure to tap subscribe to keep yourself up to date. So let's get right into it. So yes, yesterday we uploaded a video talking about the recent leaks from known leaker Clobro, talking about how there is not going to be a Battle Royale at the launch of Halo Infinite, but rather an expanded Big Team Battle 2.0. Clobro is a known leaker of information within Xbox and especially Halo, and he's been actually correct on many of his leaks. And so when he says something, it's certainly worth taking note of. And he said in a recent tweet that was taken down, but he said this, saying, "I know there won't be a Battle Royale. My limited knowledge, instead, the team is creating a Big Team Battle 2.0 mode, which is a better fit for Halo, including massively enhanced vehicular combat, squad spawning, incoming Pelican drops, and many more surprises." But that's not everything Clobro said that day. He also talked about Battle Royale and possibly being able to make it in Forge. Clobro was asked a question on Twitter, "Why is there such a bad feeling about the possible presence of a Battle Royale mode? Why do you think there won't be a Battle Royale mode?" And Clobro responded with, "Halo once was a series about setting trends, not following them. The fact 343 tries to go back to do this principle is a good thing. Forge will be massively expanded on in Halo Infinite. I'm sure if players would want to see a Battle Royale mode, players could create it." Which I think has been a general compromise a lot of people have been talking about within the community of Halo, talking about bringing Battle Royale, because I know a lot of people are apprehensive of it, because Halo has been trying to follow trends in first-person shooters really since 2010 with Halo Reach, and expanded on that in 2012 and also in 2015 with Halo 5. Ultimately, most of these additions being brought into Halo have kind of either flopped or haven't really been fully implemented to a proper degree for the Halo gameplay style. So a lot of people have said, let the developers focus on making a good Halo game first and not really bother following trends. And if people really want a Battle Royale mode in Halo Infinite, they can create it in Forge. Which seems like a fair compromise, but there actually are a lot of logistics behind that. One of those being the server size. Currently in Halo 5, there have been people that have made Battle Royale, which we'll talk about later in this video. But the hardest issue about that is, one, hardware limitations with Xbox One and Halo 5's Forge. The level of detail you can add with the map as well, it kind of breaks the immersion. You have to kind of use your imagination a little bit on that one. But also the fact that you can only have 16 players in Halo 5. Now, the only reason why that is because that's how Halo's infrastructure was built out for networking. The fun part about Battle Royale is that it's in such a large, expansive play area with so many people that once you go to the top and you win, it's a major accomplishment. And that's kind of the whole sell of Battle Royale. It's you against unsurmountable odds. The odds are literally against you and you have to come out on top. And there's only so much that a front-facing development tool like Forge can do to truly give you a better experience. Now, I did actually talk about this with a Forge creator who actually made probably the best Battle Royale map and mode I've ever seen in Halo 5. Infinite Forges, who's been making waves within the Forge community of Halo, has been really focusing on making a lot of Infinite featured content, and he actually made Halo 5 Battle Royale. I had a chance to sit down and talk with him about it and whether or not Battle Royale will be possible in Forge, how does it play out right now, what could 343 do to improve on it, and just would it be best to have it be in Forge or have a developer made Battle Royale mode? This is what he had to say. Now, I've seen a lot of comments saying that, like, why not just give people in Forge the ability to create a Battle Royale? You've created a Battle Royale in Forge. What would you say to that statement?
I think that it's awesome that we have the ability to create something that advanced. I mean, you got to think about it. The fact that you have such a limited feature, which is, it's definitely limited when you compare it to other map creators out there, but for what it is, it's incredible that Halo 5 was able to deliver on such a tool, right, for map making. However, it's definitely not easy. It takes a lot of time, a lot of patience, a lot of effort, and I do believe that it's incredibly cool that we have the opportunity, but nothing is really going to match the quality of something dev made. I feel like it'll be fun as a custom game. It'll be good for implementing ideas. It'll be good for pushing forward a narrative or a desire, right, for a certain game mode. But I don't know if it will ever, I actually know for a fact, it would never compare to a 343 created big team experience, right? Or BR experience. So I think that in the next Forge, just like in this Forge, we're gonna see an evolution of certain tools that we got prior. And that only means that if we don't get a BR, actually me and Hitbox, we plan on actually creating another version of this if there is not a battle royale. And that's going to be one of the first things that we work on.
Oh yeah.
And it's going to be massive, and it's going to be truly expansive. And if we get AI in there, in that Forge, we'll include AI. We'll make it a objective-based thing. It's going to be very insane. And to answer your question, really, I think it was just, what do you think about the ability to be able to create it? It's true. You can create it. I mean, you can go out and actually, I think Hitbox Unknown on his file share actually has, he does. He has an entire BR prefab. So if you wanted to make your own map right now, you probably could. So it's all there. The ability is there, but I only think that it's going to get better. And the next BR, the next version of this in Infinite, is going to be something truly immersive.
Yeah, because I know you mentioned when you're making this that you really came across an issue of the item limits that put into it, and like you had to remove some geometry to be able to randomize some weapon drops and things, like make it function like a battle royale.
There's a lot of limitations, yeah. And when it comes to the scripts and when it comes to just what Halo 5 isn't as that engine can handle, we were really pushing it with Halo 5 with this specific thing that we did with this battle royale. Severely pushed it to its limits.
Yeah, you definitely did. I remember playing it. There were quite a few spots where like frame drops would happen, but that's just because like at such a large scale with so much geometry, that Forge can only be optimized so well to be able to run properly. Where like a dev-made version, you could definitely kind of tweak some things and like draw distance and stuff like that within the mode itself to make it run properly.
Yeah, my last point to that though is I think Halo would be one of the most interesting and fun battle royale experiences if that ever happens.
Oh yeah,
because of the fact that it's when you played it, you were skeptical, right?
I mean, I felt like for a long time that Halo would work really well with battle royale, but obviously you don't really know how well it works until you actually play it.
But when you played it, the one big thing that I got from everyone is like, dude, I was skeptical and I actually love this, because the vehicles, the gameplay, the weaponry, everything about Halo is literally designed for that type of experience. But I just feel like it'll be a missed opportunity.
Yes, Cloverl did say that Forge will be massively expanded on, which is really great to hear. Now, depending how much they can do, what the limitations of hardware are and things like that, that all depends on what we see eventually. Probably not till later this year, so make sure you subscribe to the channel when the information does go live. Even the guy who made Battle Royale in Forge stated that it's probably best to let the developers do that. There's a lot more they can do rather than having front-facing tools like Forge. Unless Forge just becomes a straight-up developer tool that you can use a controller with, how we know Forge right now within the Halo franchise, it leaves a lot to be desired, and it's not quite on the same level of polish that a developer-made version of the mode can do. Plus, it's also just difficult to get enough people together to play in custom games unless they decide to make it in Forge, and then 343 decides to make like a dedicated playlist of that can hold like 100 plus people or something like that. But even then, that's gonna be pretty ridiculous to try to pull off. If you guys like these informational videos, make sure to tap that like button, leave a comment down below what your thoughts are on Halo Infinite having Battle Royale. Do you think it should be in Forge, or do you think it 343 themselves should make it? Check out the videos on the screen right now. If you missed any content from me recently, I'll link to all my news and informational videos right there. So thank you so much for watching. Really appreciate it. I'll catch you on the next one. Peace out.